Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. The Lakers have a busy week ahead, starting off tonight with the Denver Nuggets. And right now, they're one of just a few teams left in the NBA that have no wins. In fact, as of this recording, there's only three winless teams in the NBA, the Lakers being one of them. Certainly not a club that they want to be a part of. Joining me to discuss the level of discomfort around Lakers Nation is Mark Gunnels from LakersNation.com. Mark, how are you doing?
I'm doing good, man. How about you?
You know, I'd be doing better if the Lakers had won that game against the Blazers. Really probably should have won the game against the Clippers, too. Should be sitting at 2-1 right now, but they're not. They need to figure out a way to get a win. So let's talk a little bit about the week ahead. I also want to get into Russell Westbrook. Are we at a point where the Lakers should just sit him down or perhaps even send him home? We'll talk about that, too. But looking at the week ahead, Lakers have Denver, Minnesota, Denver. Two teams that are both expected to be well into the playoff mix in the Western Conference. Denver, a lot of people's pick to perhaps win the Western Conference. I know they haven't been great so far this season, but these should be playoff squads. What are you thinking for the Lakers this week, and how worried should we be right now?
You should be very worried. I mean, it's only three games. I understand that. It's a marathon, not a sprint, but you don't want to get too deep in a hole, especially this early in the season, especially considering the competition and how deep the Western Conference is. Thankfully, Adam Silver and the NBA made this play-in tournament thing, right? So now you kind of got a chance of even if you're a top 10 seed. So you have a little wiggle room there, but still regardless, man, 0-3, like you said, at the open, probably should be 2-1, at least 1-2. Mm-hmm. You definitely should have won that Portland game the way that unfolded. But you're 0-3, and now you have Denver twice sandwiched in between the Minnesota Timberwolves. I mean, they will not be favored in any of these games. So Vegas is going to say they're going to be 0-6. Now, I mean, you do not want to go 0-6. I think you at least got to win. I mean, you really want to win 2 out of 3, but that's a tall, tall task. But at least win a game. At least
and
win.
Then coming out of that stretch, out of the next three, next week, it's the New Orleans Pelicans, who have also been really good on the season and have been looking like, perhaps, depending on, you know, Zion Williamson's health and everything, but looking like another team that's going to be difficult to win against, that I think the Lakers also won't be favored. So that's really four games in a row here where the Lakers will not be the favorite going in. Once again, 0-3 right now on the season. I think there is some cause for concern because, again, the Western Conference is so difficult. If you fall back too far, it's really hard to make up that ground. It's going to be really tough to rise in the standings because the Western Conference is projected to be so compact. There's so many good teams that are in the West. So that's going to be a challenge for sure for the Lakers. We do have some news about Russell Westbrook. Looks like he's doubtful to play against the Denver Nuggets. Does that help the Lakers or hurt the Lakers?
I think it helps them. I think it's just a bad aura around Russell Westbrook right now. You can sense it. Obviously, when he shot that ill-advised shot at the end of that game on Sunday, you could see the reaction of LeBron and AD just completely disgusted. You know, that shot wasn't needed. It was a rush shot. And I just think the vibe of the team is just not good right now when he's in the lineup. You know, his attitude, we know that there's times where he seems to check out or, you know, it's just the aura is just not there. It's just not a good vibe in the locker room right now. And then you got a new head coach as well, a first-time head coach at that in Darvin Ham dealing with this situation, dealing with these personalities, LeBron, AD, Westbrook. I mean, that's a lot to deal with for a first-time head coach on top of being a head coach for the most prestigious franchise, maybe in all of sports, the Los Angeles Lakers. So that's a lot to deal with, man, for a first-time head coach. So I do believe him being away, just for, even for this game, I do think it does help the team because now you have more refined roles. You know that you're going to have guys that understand their roles, right? Now it's going to be more LeBron on ball. You know, obviously AD is the number two guy, probably should be number one, but, you know, that dynamic is still being worked out, I feel like. But I think it's more able to work when you don't have Westbrook and kind of in the middle, kind of getting in the way, right? So I do think it helps just for tonight. Now, does it help long-term? I can't answer that question yet, but I want to see how they play tonight without him, and then I'll be able to judge moving forward.
This game against the Nuggets, and perhaps if he's out against the Wolves, still dealing, he's dealing with a hamstring issue reportedly. If they are without him for for these next couple of games. This may inform the Lakers of what they need to do in terms of if the team starts to click, if they start to look better without him, perhaps they just sit him down, or perhaps even they send him home. As you said, if there's this kind of dark cloud hanging around Russell Westbrook, and look, it's understandable. They tried to trade him all summer. It's clear he's not a fit. He's not really wanted there. It's just a matter of time before they trade him, or at least attempt to trade him. Russ obviously has not gotten along great with Lakers fans. This has not worked out well for anybody. So it's understandable if Russ is unhappy. It's understandable if the Lakers are unhappy, if Lakers fans are unhappy. Maybe you alleviate the problem just by sending him home. But I think tonight and however many games he's out for here will go a long way towards informing that decision. If it seems like a lot of things are unlocked without Russell Westbrook there, well, then maybe that's the path forward for the Los Angeles Lakers. But we'll see. Mark, I know you've got some betting lines for us. You always do when you come on the show. What are you looking at for tonight's game?
Yeah, so I got three plays that I like tonight. I'm going to start with the point spread. Right now, I see the Nuggets are favored by 5.5. Unfortunately, and I hate when I have to do this, I'm taking the Nuggets minus 5.5. I just see no reason to believe the Lakers not only will be able to win this game, but even keep it that close. Now, obviously, with no Westbrook, maybe they do unlock some stuff, but I just can't put my money behind it until I see it first. And it's in Denver. We know how tough that place is to play with the altitude and all of those things. And they just came off a very, very embarrassing loss as well, too, against the Blazers.
To the same Blazers team. Both teams are looking to bounce back from losses to the Blazers here.
Blazers are 4-0. Who would have thought, right? But I just think at home, it's hard for me to go against the Nuggets with the 5.5. So I like that. I'm also going to take the over on the total points. It's at 229.5. The Nuggets right now are dead last in points allowed. And I think you said they're 28th in defensive rating. So you can make the case they're the worst defensive team in basketball right now. So if anybody was going to be able to get things going for the Lakers, tonight should be the night, theoretically, going against the worst defense in the league right now. So I think you're going to see a lot of points scored. Obviously, the Nuggets can put up a lot of points as well. So I like that number at 229.5 for the over. And then my last play, I got a player prop, Nikolai Jokic on assist. I like the over. It's at 8 right now. I mean, he's had games with 13, 9, 10 assists. So at eight, I think that's a very comfortable spot for me to take the over there. So those are my three plays. Nuggets minus 5.5. The over on total points at 229.5. And the over on Jokic assist at 8.
Yeah, you know, when you look at the total points over there, I think part of Denver's defensive rating and the reason why they're ranking so low is Portland shot 58% from the field against them, 46% from three. Even if they're a bad defense, those are unsustainable numbers. You're not going to shoot that consistently. So I do think that's knocked Denver down a little bit. I think they're a little bit better defensively than what those numbers would suggest because the Blazers were just red hot against them. But were they also able to get good looks because Denver's defense hasn't been good? That's also a factor in this. But I think in order for that over to hit, it's going to require the Lakers to finally start hitting threes and for progression to the mean to finally kick in. They should not be a 21% from three team. If that does happen, I do like that over that you picked there. But Mark, you've got the Nuggets winning this game. I'm going to be optimistic and say the Lakers get the win. They get the upset win because the Nuggets are a 5.5-point favorite right now. I'm going to say the Lakers find a way to get a win and finally not be sitting on zero wins this season. But Lakers Nation, give us your thoughts in the comment section down below. Can the Lakers get it done against the Denver Nuggets? And are they better off without Russell Westbrook in the rotation? Let us know your thoughts. Don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Come join us over on Playback tonight for our live stream of Lakers versus Nuggets. Till then, see ya. And stay safe.